parts of the area, all eyes are on the rivers and the streams once again. The National Weather Service predicts some areas could reach flood stage as early as tonight or tomorrow. And that's why KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney has been watching the situation. He's joining us now with a closer look. Michael.
Yeah, good evening from the Missouri River. As you can see, that squall that Brian was talking about a little bit earlier has just moved through here, and the winds are pretty substantial still. As you mentioned, flood watches and warnings are out for much of the area here along the banks of the Missouri River in downtown Kansas City. The river is clearly up, but it won't reach flood stage. That cannot be said, however, about other parts of the viewing area. This is the Missouri River upstream at Leavenworth. The Weather Service says it's about a foot over flood stage now and expected to crest another foot higher sometime late Tuesday. And it means that portions of the city's riverfront park are going back underwater again. Now, a little to the west is Stranger Creek at Easton, Kansas, a creek with a bad reputation in high water. The Weather Service says the water here has jumped 2 feet today and may rise another 6 feet by midday tomorrow. At that level, the already soggy fields around Easton will have to endure more water, and it means that some of the back roads near town may be covered, but the main highway will still be open. And Jack McAvoy's fireworks stand is also open today, and he hopes that Stranger Creek's expected rise won't cause the little town much trouble and won't cut them off.
It can at times, and you'll have to take another route to get in, but it hasn't been too bad this year.
Back live here along the Missouri River, and the winds continue to knock around. Most of the flooding, when it comes, according to the Weather Service, will be in low-lying areas, as flood stages on creeks and streams in this area are expected to rise over flood stage because of all the heavy rains.